Well, hello everyone, my name is GKami, your favorite soulless VTuber. And today, boys, we have a very important topic to discuss. Because today, we're going to be talking about respecting women.
Really need to just focus more on respecting women.
But first, how about you respect me by subscribing to my channel? I'm trying to get more subscribers, and I'm also trying to get more Twitch followers, so why don't you go follow me there as well for some fun streams? We have fun moments and sussy moments over there, so why don't you go follow me and come chill with me sometime? Come on, man. Ain't nothing wrong with hooking up with your uncle. Alright, so today we're talking about something that, ever since joining the VTubing community, I've noticed is kinda a problem. It's a problem when it comes to any kind of content creator or streamer, but I've definitely noticed it being a huge issue within the VTubing community specifically. And this was sparked by a recent stream by the guinea pig VTuber Sopralto, which I actually talked about them in my last video. But in this stream that happened recently, and I actually tuned in partway into when everything was kind of going down and had to go back and kind of see what sparked everything. But essentially what happened was that the streamer said something a little bit sus, and you know, like what most chats will do, they'll kind of hit him with the ayo pause. You know how it goes and when it comes to saying sus things in chat, not letting you get away with it, to say the least. And now before we discuss further, I think it would be best if we at least kind of look at a clip that shows everything in action.
I know I'm Clawclaw's best friend. I don't know if Clawclaw's my best friend. He's mean to me though, can you believe that? He told me he's gonna like eat my rug. No, wait, that sounds perverted. No, he like genuinely, he goes, if I have to sleep on your rug, like my carpet, he goes, I'm gonna eat it. Not like that! Oh, no! Someone hit end stream. I don't wanna talk about that. You did this to yourself. No, I didn't. I didn't mean to. I'm going to DM, I swear to God, if you DM Clawclaw, I'm going to ban you for life. I didn't mean to. I'm not a perverted mind. You guys are all perverts. We'll get our heads out of the gutter when Clawclaw gets his head out. No, stop it. No, stop it. I mean, what? Stop you. I'm not dating Clawclaw. Stop, if you don't date Clawclaw, chat will. Go ahead. I'm not dating Clawclaw. David, as a moderator, you should be respecting me right now and know that I'm not interested in Clawclaw. Yeah, chap, chill. Okay, mod, you guys cannot instigate it and then yell at chat to chill. You can't do that. That's rude to them. No, you owe us an apology. I don't have to fucking stream right now. I can end stream. I don't have to be here right now. I've already told you guys to calm down and neither are the mods paying attention. First couple times, funny. Yeah, whatever. We already did the bit. And then I purposely try to change the subject, and then you guys disrespect me repeatedly after that. That's where it starts getting really annoying. And then you start including my mods, inferring that I am either interested or dating Clawclaw. That's fucked up. I can date whoever the fuck I want to date, and I'm not dating Clawclaw. I'm not interested in him like that. So the fact that you guys do not respect my boundaries when what I've already told you, and then demand an apology from me to you for telling you to shut the fuck up, that pisses me off.
Now, as you can see by the clip, Sopralto said something a little bit sus, and obviously chat pointed it out. And at first, it was all fun and games. They laughed about it, they were making jokes about it. But the problem was that the chat unfortunately took it a bit too far. And more specifically, they just would not let the joke go. And the bigger issue is that the whole shipping thing. And well, shipping is an issue when it comes to, well, again, any content creator. It's very common that when somebody's on somebody else's stream, they'll start making up like these fake scenarios where, you know, the streamers are dating or or smash him behind the scenes. It's always been an issue, but it's definitely an issue when it comes to, well, VTubers. And I think it's partly because, well, by the nature of VTubing, because we are behind a model, unfortunately, people have a tendency to dehumanize us and want to just make us out to be whatever they want us to be, instead of remembering that behind this model is an actual person with feelings and, you know, boundaries. That's the biggest thing that we need to talk about here is, well, boundaries. Now, me, I love to make very sus jokes in other people's chats. It's kind of what I'm known for better or for worse. But even though most streamers might be okay with that, you still have to remember that every streamer is different and every streamer has, well, boundaries. Again, just like any normal person would. Sometimes there are topics they don't want you to talk about. Maybe they don't even like sus jokes in general. Maybe they're not really an 18 plus mature kind of person. And you have to recognize that and respect that. It's not your decision on what they are allowed to have in their stream. It's up to the streamer. They set their rules and it's up to you to follow them. And if you don't like those rules, then guess what? Get out. That is just the simple nature of this. If you do not like the rules, or if you do not want to follow the rules, then go watch somebody else. Because it's not up to you to come into chat and dictate what is allowed and what's not allowed, and especially not to the extent of actually pissing off a streamer and ruining and derailing a stream. And again, the shipping thing is really one of the big ones. You can't just keep saying that two people are smashing or dating. It's really gross. I kind of try not to do that. I'll make jokes if they show that they're okay with those jokes, but it's like reading the room. If a streamer shows that they're not really into the whole shipping thing, then don't do it. And yeah, I will say, Sopralto, as much as I do enjoy their content, they probably could have handled this a little bit better, right? By blowing up like they did, they kind of actually drew more attention to the problem. But at the same time, you also have to understand and also recognize that maybe this has been an issue before. I know that this has happened with a lot of VTubers very recently, actually. There was actually a situation where a streamer, I forget their name at the time, but they got into a little bit of a controversy because a Japanese idol had a message pop up on their screen. And because of that, everybody thought that the idol and the VTuber were dating and they were going fucking ballistic, as we saw with like the Rushia situation. And again, this stuff just has to stop. The parasocial bullshit needs to stop. You are there to watch and be entertained by a streamer. You're not there to date them. You're not there to even necessarily be their friend. Not to say you can't be friends with a VTuber, you can, but most likely you're not. You're a viewer. So sit back, enjoy yourself, chat with other people, and just try to have a good time. But don't make it a living hell for the person behind the screen. And I just feel like this is something that a lot of people need to realize. As VTubing has grown a lot over the past couple years, especially since the start of COVID, when it become more mainstream, you get more people watching it. But unfortunately, that brings on a bunch of unsavory people. But now that it's more prevalent and there's more people doing it, we need to start having these discussions about the etiquettes of watching VTubers and consuming VTuber content. Just because you're behind an anime model doesn't mean that the rules change whatsoever from if you were watching a flesh tuber. So people need to talk about this more, and people need to get it in their head that just because you're watching somebody using an animated model doesn't mean you can be disrespectful and not choose to respect somebody's boundaries. But hey, I don't really need to sit here for too much longer and, you know, be your dad. I ain't nobody's daddy, let's just say that. But I hope that maybe you can kind of understand where I'm coming from. This is not an issue that I've dealt with personally, but then again, I'm also very open to a lot of this stuff, so maybe it wouldn't be something that affects me as much, even if I had it happening to me. But not everybody's like that. Everybody's different, and as such, you need to read the room, and you need to figure out what is okay and what's not okay for respective streamers and their chats. But hey, that's just my thoughts and opinions on this topic. But why don't you go down there and tell me what you think? Do you agree? Do you disagree? And if you disagree, why do you disagree? I want to see what you guys have to say down below. Also, be sure to like the video if you enjoyed, subscribe if you have not already, and I hope to catch you guys in another video.